Savior, Jesus Christ. God, here we are this morning. Kneeling before y'all.
Yes, Lord.
Jesus. Come, my Father, for no shape, form, or fashion. Neither, God, do we come for an outside show to a dying world.
Yes, Lord.
We just come this morning, my Father, to let you know that we sure do appreciate it.
Yes, Lord.
We're so thankful this morning, God. My Father, we thank you for waking us up early this morning.
Yes, Lord. Thank you.
We thank you, God, that we still have a portion of our health and our strength.
Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
51st Division, verses 5 through 13, amen. 51st Division, verses 5 through 13.
Alright.
Please say amen.
Amen.
And where the Lord reads, behold, I was shaken in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me. Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow.
Make me hear joy and gladness, and that the bones beside the earth may rejoice.
Hide thy face from my sins, and blot out all my iniquities. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me.
Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and uphold me with thy free spirit.
Together, then will I teach transgressions thy way, and sinners shall be converted unto thee. Amen. The Lord have the blessings of the healers, leaders, and obeyers of this holy word.
Thank you. Thank you. Abraham didn't even know he was in the world. But the angel kept watching over him all night.
Bless them, I will.
remember them in a mighty way. And then, Lord, bless those that we don't even know anything about. Continue to just have mercy on them. Bless them in a mighty way. And then, Lord, remember Pastor Blake and his bride. Continue to just bless them. Keep them together, my Father. Bless the church, my Father. Let them go on in thy name. Father, we thank you for all that's taken place. Bless our coming together over here at Great Country. Bless our youth this morning, Lord. Let them continue to uplift and praise your holy name. Father, let them know that they are not too young to tell the Lord thank you. Continue to just let them work while it is day. For when night comes, no man can work. Bless our coming together. Then all when we have done all that we can do over here, when we have to leave this place and go on our separate ways, Lord, give us a place where we can have a head of holy breath and breathe out as we need it. In the name of Jesus, we do that for you. Amen.
Amen. nobody for them. And we know that he's real.
Son and for his daughters. But David encouraged himself in the Lord his God. For a few minutes, we're going to talk about what to do when you don't know what to do. What to do when you don't know what to do. Grass shall wither, flowers shall fade, the word of my God shall never will stand forever. What to do when you just don't know what to do. As I looked at the text and I saw the dilemma of King David and his army, my mind went back to one of those hymns that lets us know that time is filled with swift transitions. You're up today and down today. You're a picture of health today and in hospice care tomorrow. From a stable marriage to an unstable one. From a strong 401k to just a cake. What do you do in an unstable economy? What do you do when you handle a pink slip on the job and you keep in debt? What do you do when you don't know what to do? My brothers and sisters, I've learned that in the time of trouble, he'll hide you in the secret of his tabernacle. I learned, my brothers and sisters, in the time of trouble, when you have been put afflictions upon you, that's the time to look to the hill from which cometh all.
Where to turn to.
I found myself doing what the Lord told me to do,
to the wrong sources. I wish I had somebody to know. In the midst of your storm, that you just ought to run to Jesus. Run to the Lord. Jerry Springer has been canceled, so you can't run to him. You've been running to the wrong sources. You've been running to Ariana, and her show may not come back next season. You're running to all my children, and misery loves company. You're running into Days of Our Lives, and you're running to the young and restless, and Victor still ain't getting no better. You're running to the wrong sources. Hear me now, dude. You are run to the rock. And when you run to the rock, he'll be able to walk through some things. Run to him that can turn any situation that you might be going through. All right.
Yes, sir.
Run to him. When you got health problems.
Amen.
Run to him when you got marital problems. Run to him when you got financial problems. Run to him when things just ain't well on the inside of you. Run to him when family and friends forsake you. Run to him that when the sun is not shining in your life, because he has a way of turning things around in your life. And he's sitting right there. I'm just waiting on him to say something. I'm just waiting on them to ask me what they need, because I got all the power that they need in the palm of my hand. I'm just waiting on them to ask. And that's a lot of our problem is we run into the wrong sources instead of running to God. Because when we find ourselves running to God, he'll have everything we need.
Amen.
Look at the text for a minute. King David and his army have made their way home to Ziklag. And when they make their way home to Ziklag, they find out that their wives, their sons, and their daughters are all gone. All of their stuff has been burned to the ground by the Amalekites. What do you do when you come home and everything that you own is gone? Children gone. House gone. Cattle gone. Crops gone. What do you do in a time like that? Job tells us what to do. He says, I know what to do when everything like that happens to you. I'm going to keep my integrity, and I'm going to say, naked I came into the world, and naked I shall return, but blessed be the name of the Lord. In your time of decision, when things are not good in your life, you still owe God a praise. And when you still know that you're in the trouble that you're in, Job says, I got something else to say. I say, no, but I know you're trying to teach me something, and I'm asking you for your help, because I'm just leaning and depending on you. And when I lean and depend on you, you told me if I ask and if I would just try to live right, you'll come and answer.
Yes, yes, thank you, Lord.
Yes. David came home.
Yes.
Crops burned. Wives gone. Children gone. Daughters gone.
Everything's gone.
And it's all me. I'm ready to turn on. The question has to be asked again. What do you do when you don't know what to do? three things I want you to see. And we get ready to get out of here. You can't let emotion verse logic. You can't let your emotion versus logic. David didn't do more, no burning down of the house. He didn't burn the crops. He didn't take the children. He didn't take the wives. But the men are ready to kill him. You can't let your emotions versus your logic.
That's right.
And oftentimes we let our emotions overrule our logic.
Teach that.
And when we let emotion overrule our logic, we make a bunch of mistakes and make things worse than it already is. When we let emotion overrule logic, we don't say, let's kill the preacher. When God says, touch not my anointed and do my prophet no harm. When we let emotion overrule logic, we'll walk away from what God has given us.
Yes, sir.
When we let emotion overrule logic, we'll just do a bunch of things that instead of making it better, it gets worse and worse and worse. That's why you can't let emotion overrule your logic. Disaster does not mean God is absent from your situation. And you have to understand, God is
right there
with you.
Amen.
Even as you go through and you don't know what to do, be still and know that I am a God that can do anything but faith. In the midst of his absence, in personal distress, we gain strength through knowing that God's presence is still right there. You got to take the time and you got to listen to the scripture. And when you take the time and you listen to the scripture will tell you something. Though I may be absent, I'm still with you. Even though you may not can see me in the physical, I'm right there behind the scenes making a way of provision for you. He's there with you. But you got to let logic overrule emotion. At the time of weakness, it's there when we get strong. What do you mean? David started praying. And when things come in our lives that we don't know what to do, the best weapon you have is prayer. But it seems that we start leaning to our own understanding instead of all of your ways acknowledging him and let him direct your path. But that comes a time to where we say we know better than God. When we say, God, we don't need your help today. Go ahead and look at somebody else's life, but I don't need your help today. I made the decision and this is what I'm going to do, and you mess it up a little bit more, and 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 a little bit more. And when you get down to the bottom of the bottom, that's when you're ready to call on God to fix the situation when you should have went to him first. And that's what David did in the text. He went to the bottom. Even though I am a man of high position, I'm the king, I still need some help. Even though I got proceeds, I got the kingdom, men will go where I tell them to go, say what I tell them to say, I still need help from the Lord. Look, you got your degree. You got letters behind your name. You drive the right car. You live in the right neighborhood. Everything is 86 and 14 in your life, but you still need God. Oh, no, no, no. You've been here in the church a long time. You look good, you talk good, but you still need help from the Lord. No. You sent your children to the right prep schools. You sent them to the right college, but you still need God.
Yeah.
Never get to a point to where you think that you can take God and say, I don't need you. I need you every day, every hour, every minute, every second, because I know I cannot make it without you. That's why we need to pray, because he told us in his word that man ought to always pray and not pray. And the only thing he's saying is man ought to pray and pray constantly. You ought to pray in the morning, pray in the evening, pray when the sun goes down, from the rising of the sun to the going down of the sun. God needs to know your God kept a track record of the last time you talked to him. Some of us would say it was back in 1977. And here it is 2018.
Yeah, I hear you now.
And here I am, Lord, weeping and bye-bye. And Lord, we come right now asking you for a blessing. And the last time I talked to you, Lord, I didn't have glasses. But here it is the day I got glasses. And I need your help. No, God wants to hear from you in the good times as well as the bad times. He wants to hear from you in the good seasons as well as the bad seasons. Because God still wants to know. Nobody wants to be used. If you can only call me in the time of trouble. I see something else in the case. We got to stand together. We got to stand together. We got to stand together. It's right there in the text. We want to turn on one another when things go bad.
Yeah.
All right. And that's the time we need to stand together.
Amen.
Yeah. David puts it like this in the 100 Numbers of Psalms. How good. 130 Numbers of Psalms. How good. And how pleasant it is. For brethren to dwell together in unity. It's good to be on one accord when the sun is shining. But we got to be together on one accord even when it ain't shining. It may be storming in our lives, but we still need to be together. Because if we are together in any situation that we find ourselves in, the devil will never be able to put no hurt, harm, and danger on any of us. Because we're together. Even when we don't like the situation that we're going in that's being led to us by God, we're going to say, I don't like it, I don't think it's a good idea, but we're going to move with God anyhow. I watched that movie 300 the other day. And it showed us how unified they were. When one made the commandment to hold up the shield, everybody just held up the shield.
That's right.
When the commandment was made to throw the spear at the same time, all of them threw the spear. Because they were all one accord.
Amen.
And as I was watching it, I got to thinking, wait a minute. This is a picture of the church.
Yeah.
If the commandment would only say, hold up the spear, and we all hold up the spear, when the commander gives us the command to hold on the spear, and we all throw the spear at the same time, the devil wouldn't know what to do.
Yes, sir.
If an urchin falls, the choir feels it.
Yeah.
When a choir member falls, the urchin will feel it.
Yeah.
When the urchin, whatever department that the church that may be hurting, when we are one in Christ, we lift each other up.
Amen.
Because we are one.
Yeah.
And since we are one, we don't turn
what we should do.
See, one of those things, it takes me to get ready to get out of here. Look at verse 15, when you get home, look at verses 11 through 15. See, because God is always working behind the scenes when you're crying. And when you get home and you read verses 11 through 15, you're going to see rejected but still useful. There is a young servant that the Amalekites left behind. He got sick. And as he got sick, the Amalekites left him for dead. They just left him on the side of the road. And just about time David got ready to pursue after the Amalekites, the one that they rejected was the one God used to get their stuff back.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Brothers and sisters, we got to quit overlooking folk that don't look like us,
amen,
talk like us,
yeah,
and live like us.
Right.
Because what we reject may be the one God wanted to use.
Yes, sir.
He was right there, ready to die when David had compassion on him. Your stuff back. Everything that the devil stole from you, is not Williams. Even when we think he's not near. And I believe you now, brothers and sisters. May the Lord bless you real good.
Go ahead, son.
And cause his face to shine upon you.
Go ahead.
And give you peace. That made up in my mind. And that God has brought me too far to leave me. And since he brought me too far just to leave me, I'ma let the storm rage. I'ma let the wind blow. I'ma let the wind blow. And the reason why